Prompt engineering is a crucial aspect of developing effective generative AI systems. It involves carefully crafting the prompts or inputs provided to the model to elicit the desired outputs. This lesson will explore the principles and techniques of prompt engineering, enabling you to optimize the performance and reliability of your generative AI applications. We will dive into strategies for structuring prompts, incorporating context and constraints, and leveraging techniques like few-shot learning and chain-of-thought prompting. This lesson will cover various aspects of prompt engineering to enhance the performance and reliability of generative AI models. We'll explore inference parameters, which are settings and hyperparameters that can be adjusted during the model's inference or generation phase to influence its behavior, such as randomness, output length, and adherence to constraints. Additionally, the lesson will delve into best practices for structuring prompts effectively, incorporating relevant context and constraints, and leveraging techniques like few-shot learning and chain-of-thought prompting. These strategies aim to improve the model's understanding and performance on the intended task. Furthermore, the concept of in-context learning will be discussed, which is a paradigm where the model learns to adapt its behavior based on the context provided within the prompt itself. This approach allows the model to dynamically adjust its knowledge and capabilities without explicit fine-tuning or retraining, enabling more flexible and versatile language generation. Let's discuss prompt engineering, a way to optimize prompts. Prompts are the key inputs that guide language models to generate desired responses for specific tasks. They typically take the form of natural language queries or instructions, allowing users to clearly communicate their intent and requirements to the model. Through prompts, users can provide detailed explanations of the task at hand, set constraints or boundaries for the model's response, offer examples to illustrate the desired output, and even specify the preferred format for the generated content. This level of control and customization ensures that the model's output aligns with the user's goals and expectations. A prompt is composed of various components that work together to guide a language model in generating the desired response. Let's take this example prompt to analyze the various components of the prompt. The input data serves as the raw material for the model to process and understand the context. The instruction component specifies the task or action the model should perform, such as classification, summarization, or generation. Providing additional context helps guide the model's response by supplying relevant background information or constraints. Specifying the desired output format is equally important as it allows the model to structure its response appropriately, whether it's a bulleted list, a paragraph, or a specific data format. Crafting high-quality prompts requires careful consideration of these components, ensuring clear and specific instructions, relevant contextual information, and a well-defined output format. Observe the highlighted components of the prompt in the example. Prompt engineering is an art that unlocks the full potential of a given language model. Prompt engineering is an iterative approach, often requiring multiple refinements to achieve optimal prompts that ensure accuracy, relevance, and coherence in the generated outputs. The quality and structure of prompts play a crucial role in influencing the performance of LLMs. Well-designed prompts can mitigate the risk of hallucinations, which are inaccurate or fabricated outputs generated by the models. Prompt engineering encompasses various techniques, ranging from established best practices to cutting-edge research methods. This field is rapidly evolving, with researchers and practitioners continuously exploring new approaches to enhance the effectiveness of prompts. The systematic design and optimization of prompts aim to unlock the full potential of LLMs, enabling them to generate more reliable and coherent responses across a wide range of applications. Let's move on to the topic of inference parameters. This is an important aspect when working with language models, as the choice of inference parameters can significantly impact the model's performance and the quality of the generated outputs. We'll delve into the details and considerations around setting appropriate inference parameters in this section. Inference parameters help control and customize the model's response during inference or prediction. They do not affect the model architecture or weights, but rather influence the output generation process. These parameters can impact various aspects of the model's behavior, such as creativity and diversity in responses, confidence levels, response length, and determining when to end the response generation. By adjusting inference parameters, users can control the model's outputs to align with their specific requirements. The temperature parameter controls the randomness or diversity in the generated text output. A temperature of 0 makes the output completely deterministic, while higher temperature values introduce more randomness, leading to more diverse and creative responses. A temperature of 0 will cause the model to generate the same response for a given prompt in each run. Increasing the temperature allows the model's generation to sample other tokens with higher probability, generating diverse responses for the same prompt. A very high temperature makes the model's response highly diverse and creative, but may increase the likelihood of hallucinations. Top P and Top K are techniques for sampling the next token or word during text generation. Top P selects the next word from the set of words whose cumulative probabilities sum up to the specified p-value. Top K simply picks the next token from the top K most probable options according to the model's predictions. The maximum number of tokens parameter sets a limit on the length of the generated response. If this value is set too low, the model may produce incomplete or truncated responses. Stop sequences are specific sequences of text that instruct the model to stop generating further output when encountered. This allows controlling when the response should end based on certain conditions or patterns in the generated text. These inference parameters provide flexibility in controlling the model's behavior during inference, enabling users to strike a balance between diversity, coherence, and response length based on their specific requirements. In this section, we will discuss some best practices in prompt engineering. Following best practices in this area is crucial for effectively leveraging the capabilities of these models and obtaining high-quality outputs. Good prompting practices play a crucial role in effectively utilizing language models and obtaining high-quality outputs that align with your requirements. Clarity and specificity are paramount when crafting instructions, as ambiguity can lead to misinterpretations and undesired results. Highlighting or explicitly specifying the aspects of the prompt that the model should prioritize helps ensure that it focuses on the most relevant information. Incorporating relevant details or constraints into the prompt allows you to shape the output according to your specific needs. For instance, you can provide context, set boundaries, or specify desired characteristics to guide the model's response in the intended direction. Separating the instruction, content, question, and output directions into distinct components enhances clarity and makes it easier for the model to understand and follow the different elements of the prompt. This structured approach can lead to more coherent and focused outputs. Positive instructions, which frame the task in a constructive manner, are generally preferred over negative ones, as they provide a more encouraging and productive framing for the model to work with. Importantly, finding the optimal prompt is often an iterative process that requires multiple attempts and refinements. It may involve experimenting with different phrasings, adjusting the level of detail or specificity, or incorporating additional constraints or context. Instruction-tuned LLMs are further fine-tuned to generate responses to textual instructions. This enables them to generate content that aligns closely with user intent by following guidelines to arrive at desired outcomes. The key advantage of instruction-tuned models is their ability to understand and respond to prompts in a way that aligns with the user's goals. By providing clear and specific instructions, users can guide the model to generate relevant and tailored content. This makes instruction-tuned LLMs particularly useful for tasks that require understanding and following instructions. This level of control and specificity in content generation is a significant advantage over traditional language models, which may generate more generic or unfocused outputs. Different large language models might require specific prompt formats to work optimally. it's important to refer to the model documentation or guidelines to understand the recommended prompt structure. For example, Anthropic's Claude models have been trained on an alternating human and assistant dialogue format, so prompts should replicate this structure. Properly formatting prompts according to the model's requirements can significantly improve performance and ensure the model understands and responds appropriately to the given instructions. Let's discuss two more strategies to optimize inference. Quantization is a technique that involves loading the model weights into a lower precision data type, such as using 8-bit or 4-bit floating point numbers instead of higher precision formats such as 16-bit or even 32-bit. This reduces the memory footprint of the model and lowers the computational requirements, enabling faster inference times. However, quantization needs to be applied judiciously to minimize any potential loss in model performance. Another strategy to accelerate inference is to use batch predictions instead of processing inputs one by one. By processing multiple inputs simultaneously in batches, the model can leverage parallelization and optimize computational efficiency, especially when running on GPUs. This batching approach can significantly speed up inference times compared to iterative single predictions. Cost-effective strategies when querying large language models through APIs involve being aware of the cost structure. This typically depends on the length of the prompt, the length of the response, and the cost per query. As a rule of thumb, one token corresponds to approximately 4 characters of text, and 100 tokens is roughly equivalent to 75 words. Understanding these factors allows you to optimize your prompts and manage costs effectively when interacting with LLM APIs for various applications and use cases. Cost-effective strategies when querying API include controlling the length of the response. Set inference parameters, such as max new tokens, to limit the output size. Adding instructions in the prompt like be concise or answer in less than 50 words can also help reduce response length. Shortening prompts or combining multiple prompts into one can reduce input length and cost. Testing more cost-effective LLMs or using smaller, cheaper APIs are other potential strategies to consider for optimizing costs when querying language models. Let's discuss in-context learning. It refers to the ability of large language models to understand and follow instructions or prompts provided within the input context itself. In-context learning is a common adaptation method where the model is not updated, but provided with some instructions for different tasks. For example, large language models can be asked to perform text classification, summarization, and question and answering tasks simply by providing the relevant instructions. Additionally, the model can be given some correct examples of the task to further guide its understanding and performance. This approach allows for flexible and efficient adaptation without the need for retraining or fine-tuning on new data. By leveraging the context and examples provided in the prompt, language models can effectively adapt their capabilities to handle a wide range of tasks and domains, making in-context learning a powerful and versatile technique in natural language processing. Zero-shot learning refers to the ability of large language models to generate responses solely based on instructions, without being explicitly shown demonstrations of the task at hand. This allows the models to perform tasks that were not part of their core training objective, such as translation, summarization, arithmetic reasoning, and more. The models leverage their generalized understanding of concepts acquired during pre-training to exhibit these emergent abilities. For example, when prompted with the instruction, "Translate from English to Spanish," and given the input, "cat," the model can generate the output, "gato," by drawing upon its understanding of language and translation, even though it was not explicitly trained on this specific task. One-shot learning refers to cases where a single example and the corresponding instruction are provided to the model. The goal is to demonstrate how to perform a specific task using that one example. The example serves as a guide, allowing the model to understand the task requirements and generalize from that single instance. In the illustration, the prompt provides an example sentence, "Cat is an animal," and asks the model to complete the next sentence, table is, based on that example. The model's output, a piece of furniture, correctly identifies the category or type of object that a table belongs to, following the pattern established by the example. By leveraging the model's ability to learn from a single example, it can quickly adapt to new tasks or domains without fine-tuning. Few-shot learning refers to cases where multiple examples and the instruction are provided in the prompt. This allows the model to identify patterns across the examples and apply them directly to the given task. The slide illustrates this concept with an example prompt that includes three sentences. Cat is not a piece of furniture. Table is not an animal. And car is. The instruction asks to complete the last sentence based on the provided examples. The model's output is not a living thing, correctly identifying the pattern. Few-shot learning is beneficial when multiple examples can provide useful context and guidance for the task at hand, enabling the model to effectively generalize from a small number of instances. Sentiment analysis is a technique used to identify and extract subjective information from text data, such as opinions, emotions, attitudes, and feelings. It involves analyzing the sentiment expressed in text, whether it is positive, negative, or neutral. Sentiment analysis has numerous applications, including monitoring customer feedback, analyzing social media sentiment, and understanding public opinion on various topics. It can be performed using machine learning models trained on labeled data or through unsupervised techniques that leverage lexicons and rules. Sentiment analysis is a valuable tool for businesses, organizations, and researchers to gain insights into people's opinions and sentiments expressed in textual data. Text summarization is the process of generating a concise summary that captures the most important information from a larger text document or a set of documents. The goal is to distill the key points and essential details into a condensed form, while preserving the overall meaning and context of the original text. This task is particularly useful when dealing with large volumes of textual data, as it allows for efficient information extraction and comprehension. The slide provides an example of text summarization with zero-shot inference, where a longer text about the increase in EV sales is summarized into a single sentence. This slide discusses several examples of tasks that can be accomplished using zero-shot prompting with large language models. Personalized content generation allows tailoring explanations or descriptions to specific audiences, like explaining a concept to high school students using relatable language. Code generation showcases the ability to produce functional code snippets, such as writing Python code to read CSV files for data analysis. Information extraction tasks test comprehension by identifying relevant details from given text, like determining the year mentioned in a sentence. The examples also include straightforward question-answering tasks that assess general knowledge and reasoning capabilities, such as asking about common facts like the number of days in a year or the capital of a country. These diverse examples highlight how large language models can leverage their broad knowledge to perform various tasks by understanding the context and intent behind prompts, without needing extensive task-specific training data or fine-tuning. This lesson covered prompt engineering and in-context learning. In the next lesson, you will explore some advanced prompting techniques. Thank you for your interest and engagement.